This is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today I'll be talking about the Garden Challenge 350, and more information on that is at igrowsonoma.org. We're standing here in a beautiful front yard here in Sonoma County, and the project for iGrow 350 is to put in a minimum of 350 gardens on May 15th and 16th. Garden Challenge 350 is here basically to improve the health of the residents and sponsored by Health Action. It's a project of Health Action, which is basically a Department of Health Services here in Sonoma County. So it's really progressive. I think it's a great idea, and there should be more counties around the country that are doing this and promoting, community coming together and working together to put in more gardens so people could eat healthier and we could reduce carbon emissions, because the food, if you grew it in your front yard or in your backyard, you know, your food won't have to travel as far. You're going to get a fresher quality food. You're going to be eating better quality food, and you're gonna be healthier in the long run. So on May 15th and 16th, I'm proud to say that I'll be helping a friend put in some raised beds in his backyard. Today, what I'm here to do is to show you what I've done in my front yard here in Sonoma County and encourage everybody to convert their lawn. I mean, we're standing in a residential lawn here, standard house, and most all my neighbors all around me all have lawns, and it's an incredible waste of resources. It takes a lot of fertilizers and chemicals to keep your lawn green and looking good without weeds and all that stuff. And there's a better way. You could use your space instead of your lawn to grow your own food. This is a standard residential home. I'm about on a 7,000 square foot lot, and I've converted the whole front yard into a raised bed edible garden. And you know, I've been growing for about 10 years, like off in the periphery, and most people have a periphery garden, and the iGrow Garden Challenge is not about converting your whole front lawn. That'd be great if you did it, but it's about just planting one new plant in a potter if you have a condo or apartment or anything, planting something new, planting some herbs, some fruits, or some vegetables. Plant a tree. That's great. We want to encourage people to grow their own food at home. So let's come into my garden and I'll show you just some of the things that I'm growing today. So here's a nice one. This is broccoli. And when the broccoli, this is a little bit past how they would harvest it in the store. When the broccoli gets larger, it goes to flower, and these are the little flowers. And we could step over here to the next one. And the flowers are definitely still edible. You could eat the broccoli flowers. They're good to eat. And what people don't know is that you could also eat your broccoli leaves. So the whole part of the broccoli, not only the flowers, but the leaves are also edible. They're just like kale or collards. I had a pre-existing fig tree that I had planted many years ago. And even space under the fig tree can be used. Now, we're coming out of winter time, so this is the remainder of my winter garden, and pretty soon the fig tree leaves will fill in so much that it'll shade out pretty much everything underneath. But in the off season, in the winter time, I planned a winter garden. So we have some kohlrabi here. Kohlrabi is an excellent vegetable. And here it is right here. We just pulled it out. As you can see, the root mass is not that big, so a lot of raised beds can be as short as, you know, 12 inches high off the ground, and that's gonna be perfect. And so this kohlrabi plant here, it's another cruciferous vegetable. And once again, you could eat these leaves just like you would collards or kale. You could cut them up into a salad, eat them raw. You could juice them, blend them up into green smoothies. They're really good to eat. But the main reason why they grow the kohlrabi is for these edible bulbs. And now see, this is the root mass down here, and this is the bulb. So you'd basically peel off all this, and it's a nice crunchy bulb. It's great to eat. It's like eating broccoli stem, if you've ever eaten broccoli stem, just peeling off the broccoli stem and then eating the middle. So juicy. It's gonna be so good. I'm gonna eat that later today. So I have about 8 raised beds here in my front yard. They're approximately 4 feet wide by 15 feet long. This one here is planted out in strawberries. Almost 100 strawberry plants fit in this one bed, and that's gonna make a couple flats of strawberries for me. I already got some ripening up. They're actually purchased locally at Sank Farms. You can visit their website, sankfarms.com. They're a great resource to buy some starts. Right now they have tomato and pepper and other starts. Very affordable price. Next door here we have a pepper bed. And we have, I don't know, probably over 70 peppers planted in this bed. I love peppers, a variety of hot and sweet peppers. Here in Sonoma County you can grow many different things, especially in the summertime. Our climate's really great. And I'm gonna grow a lot of the different summer vegetables, such as the peppers and tomatoes. We're gonna plant out the cucumbers here really soon. But you could also grow year-round, so don't forget about your garden in the wintertime, because you could still grow things. Some of the things that grow really good in the wintertime are this bed right here. This was my remainder of my winter garden. I grew cauliflower, red boar kale, dino kale, curly kale, red Russian kale here, all kinds of things. And once the plants get more mature, you know, they stop really making good leaf production. They go into the flowering stage. So here's some of the flowers that we didn't cut off. We're trying to cut the flowers off so it'll make more leaves. But the flowers are edible. And if you take a look at these flowers here, these flowers look just like little broccolis, and you could eat them as such. Mmm. So here's another bed that I planted. It's on my property line. This bed is 4 feet wide by about 40 feet long. And we have a number of plants here, along with my fruit trees planted out every 6 feet. We're interplanting tomatoes, and we have all these beautiful flowers. So we have marigolds, pansies, and violas. They're all edible. I encourage everybody to plant some edible flowers. They not only attract beneficial insects, but they're also tasty and really good. And we planted the tomato plants here in between with these cages about 20 inches apart. I'm using what's called square foot gardening, which basically allows you to pack more plants in a tighter area when you're growing in raised beds, and you could control the soil and have good soil to grow in. Now I'm standing next to my perennial tree collards. These tree collards are probably about 12 feet tall now. They're purchased at one of the arts and ecology centers out in Occidental's plant sale. And I think the tree collards are a really smart vegetable to plant. These are what's called perennial vegetables. So like the other collards and kales that you saw over there, they go to flower and then they basically stop production. These ones continue to grow all year long in Sonoma County. And you could just sit here and come and pick the leaves and just keep picking them, and they keep growing and keep eating them. They're just so good, especially in the winter time. They get a lot sweeter. In front of me, I have my herb garden with all different kinds of herbs growing. And behind me, I really like to grow vertically because I have a small lot. So it's really important to train your plants to grow vertically so you could maximize the space that you have, especially if you have a little space. So against the wall here, I have some grape trellises, and the grapes are growing really well. They probably could use a little bit better sun, but grapes were a nice thing I could fill in on this wall, which is my garage wall, to maximize my use of the space. And I have all seeded varieties, and actually wine varieties of grapes. And I encourage everybody to plant seeded varieties and wine varieties of the grapes, because the wine grapes are actually grown for their sweetness, because it's the sugar content in the wine grapes that ferment into the alcohol. All right, so now I'm sitting on my bed, my herb bed. We have all these nice sides so we could sit down and rest on or work on here in the garden. And, you know, I wanted to go over a couple of reasons why I garden. So, you know, primarily I garden, number one, for the health of it. You know, our food system in the United States is really messed up. Basically, there's big companies growing our food, and, you know, most of us don't know where our food comes from. Even if you're buying it at the local farmer's market, that's definitely a step in the right direction. But the most sustainable is that for every American in the United States and everybody here in Sonoma County to grow their own food or a portion of their own food, where they could literally walk out their door. And, you know, there's no need for refrigerators if you grow your own food. You know, I don't pick things until I'm going to eat it. I come outside, come out, and, oh, I want parsley for dinner. Pick my parsley, bring it inside, and eat it right then and there. Nothing better than that. So the quality of food is much better. You're going to be eating healthier food, things that you grow. I mean, some of the things that you pick it after 24 hours, it loses 50% of some of the nutrition, or some of the vitamins and things degrade. And, you know, most of the time, luckily we're here in California, so food doesn't have to travel that far. But think about if you're in New York and you're getting the food from California, you know, it's 10 days old by the time it gets there, and it's lost some of its nutrition. So we want to maximize the nutrition. Another reason, the taste for chefs and people like that really like flavors and tastes, things that you grow and you pick taste a lot better. So that's definitely a good reason also to grow your food. It's just more sustainable for the planet, tastes better, healthier. We're lucky to have some great resources here in Sonoma County to be able to garden fairly affordably. The first resource I'd like to mention, number one, is Sonoma Compost on Meacham Road in Petaluma. They basically take all our green bins and yard waste and food scraps and compost that for you, and then sell it back to you at a really affordable price. All my beds are filled up with a mixture of the Sonoma compost and just one other thing primarily. It's called rock dust or glacial rock dust. And I highly recommend just using basically these two things. You can maybe mix in some soil if you'd like as well. But with those two things, you're going to produce some very good results. What is rock dust? Well, rock dust are basically ground up glacial rocks to add the minerals back in the soil, because the minerals are basically, all our topsoils are devoid of minerals. We need to add minerals back into the soil. You're going to have healthier plants with higher yields, and they're going to taste better too. So where do you get the rock dust minerals? There's a great place on Sebastopol Road in Santa Rosa called Lee Ballister's, and they're basically a fertilizer shop that sells fertilizers for big farms, but they'll also sell to individuals. So you could go in there and buy a bag of the rock dust. It's approximately $15 per 50-pound bag, which is a really good deal, and I encourage everybody to use rock dust. It'll basically make your leaves much larger, make everything grow larger, and taste much better. So I hope I've encouraged you to start growing something either on May 15th or 16th, or if you live in Sonoma County, just start planting a garden. You don't have to convert your whole front yard like I did. Start in a pot, make one raised bed in your backyard, in your front yard, but make sure it's definitely the sunniest area that you could possibly find. So this is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com, and we'll see you next time.